rise for a moment of silence for and remember Dennis Simmons, our former legislator, again, and the Pledge of Allegiance. Okay, roll call.
Bonsack. Turnbull. Amo.
Here.
Anagnestakis.
Present.
Benton. Berkman.
Here.
Benelli. Cantorino.
Here.
Cheney.
Here.
Dillard. DeSalvo.
Present.
Ekis.
Here.
Fagion.
Here.
Hines.
Here.
Chemnitz.
Here.
Corsack. Paduk.
Here.
Ruskovich.
Here.
Sullivan.
Here.
Vero.
Here.
Gresha.
Here.
18 present, 3 absent.
Okay, first we have 3 recognition awards, proclamations, and a certificate. First off, I'd like to invite up Dr. Avila and the Quinones family, and Victor Manuel Quinones, his parents, family. And the county exec will come down, please, as well. We'll do that one first. Doctor, you want to say a little bit about Victor? I mean, I know Victor since he was about this high. He grew up in the village of Montgomery, and his father, parents, Victor, and Mrs. Quinones, and known him a long time, and I'm very proud of him. But do you want to give a little history? I know you have no shortage of words.
We just came from a press conference, so he's a little worn out.
That's correct. Good afternoon. It's a real honor to be here with my cousin, Victor Quinones, and his son, Victor Quinones III. And I can say I met Victor Quinones when he was 2 weeks old. They were in a bad part of the, I remember Brooklyn, was it Brooklyn? I remember going up four stories, carrying him in my arms. And I'm very proud to say that I followed his career. He actually worked with Dr. Hudson and worked at the ATUPA program, which is the undercover teenagers that buy cigarettes from the bad actors that I prosecute. And he grew up, had honors at John Jay, and went on to become a decorated PA state trooper. I actually had the honor when I was confirmed to have him assigned to me, which was wonderful because his bosses were wondering, how did you get that detail? I had no idea that he was with me on confirmation day back in 2011. So it's always, we always have this fun play, and makes me very happy to know that one of our own here in Orange County has done really well. The FBI has recognized him for some of the work he's done. And it's just a real honor to see our children grow up and serve society in such a positive manner. And I thank the legislature for bestowing this honor on me and my family.
Well, we just, the last 2 years have been the most dangerous for law enforcement across America. And I think the legislature, I know they stand solid with me and the county. We've had a couple instances here where we've had prayer vigils and we've had signs of solidarity. We just had a rally a month ago at the jail right across the property from here, supporting law enforcement and trying to get the word out across at least our community that we need to come out and support law enforcement. And you were a perfect example. If they're coming, I call him a homeboy. I know you carried him in Brooklyn, but he grew up in Montgomery.
That's right.
So
that's right.
I think the chairman will take the credit for the community that they have there for helping raise such a good young member of public safety. So we definitely salute you, and we thank you for what you do, not only for PA, but you guys are always on duty. So thank you very much.
Absolutely.
I'm very proud of you. You are a Montgomery boy first. Don't forget that. Right? Come from good stock. I know, Victor, you still working at the courts over in Dutchess?
Yes, sir.
In Poughkeepsie? Great family. Is this all your family here?
Yes.
Thanks for coming.
My brother, my sister, and my 3 children, and my beautiful, lovely wife, Rachel, who is the reason I ended up in Pennsylvania in the first place.
No,
that's okay. You know, we like Pennsylvania. We'd rather have in New York, but Pennsylvania, it's their game, so. But thanks, thank you all for coming. We have a big proclamation for you, and if you want to say a few words. Proclamation from the Orange County Legislature. The outstanding accomplishments of Victor Manuel Quinones III, Orange County resident and Pennsylvania State Trooper. Whereas putting the safety and protection of all citizens before one's own represents the highest example of public service which we can possibly be rendered. And strengthens the stable, and talk today again, democratic structure of our system of self-government. And whereas Victor Manuel Quinones III has been a resident of Montgomery, New York since 1999 and attended middle and high school in Orange County where he received his Regents Diploma with honors, who, among American high school students, he attended Orange County Ulster Bolsey's Law Enforcement and Criminal Justice Academy, National Technical Honors Society, and graduated from John Jay College of Criminal Justice, City of New York, CUNY, cum laude honors, major in criminal justice and minor in English, all while still residing in Montgomery, New York. Whereas during his high school years, he was an undercover youth volunteer in the Orange County ATUPA, Adolescent Tobacco Use Prevention Act program. His volunteerism would pave the way for his law enforcement career. The County of Orange has been blessed with a tradition of fostering the development of leadership in our young people who provide service to the community and dedicate their lives to American ideals. And Victor Manuel Quinones III is a shining example. And whereas Victor Manuel Quinones III has continued to serve in the Pennsylvania State Police and its citizens since 2009 with unwavering dedication, steadfastness, and devotion to the principles of a system of laws. Now, therefore, we, the legislature of the County of Orange, on behalf of ourselves and all of our citizens of the county, do hereby proclaim that these sentiments be published among all the citizens of Orange County so that all may be mindful of the good works of Orange County resident and Pennsylvania State Trooper Victor Manuel Quinones III, for the general welfare and accord to him all due appreciation, esteem, and respect. Given this day, September 2016, L. Steve Gresha, Chairman, County Legislature.
How are y'all? Thank you for coming. I won't take up too much time, but I did want to say thank you. I'm grateful to God because I feel so blessed, and it was a surprise to hear that I've been recognized in this way, especially from Mayor Gresha, because I know him, like he said, since I was a young man in school. Not just that I knew of him, but I saw him in my school and in the community around town. And I heard of him, I didn't just read about him in the newspapers. And it was always some good people saying good things. And when I moved to the village of Montgomery, things were really different, and it was really good for me. The community in the village and the community in the county, it was just a really good, great place to live and to work and to learn. And I feel like you all helped me to get where I am here today. Valley Central School District, great teachers, educational programs, Orange Ulster BOCES, law enforcement program, Don Weber from the program, who made me sit down and put the application in for John Jay, Mr. Dietrich, and a TUBA program, gave my first real job interview. I mean, really, it's about community, and I feel very privileged and honored that I was part of the village of Montgomery and Orange County as a whole. It's all of you guys that make the county what it is, and I see a lot of different types of communities in a lot of different places because of the nature of the job that I do. You guys live in a really good place, and it's you guys, but it's also the legislature. You know, I thank you guys for doing your jobs and working hard, because I know you make some hard decisions. And you create and maintain that community. And so I thank you guys, and I want y'all to feel appreciated the way you're making me feel appreciated today. So thank you very much. And of course, always thank my family, thank all your families.
You're number one. Thank you again, Victor, and Quinones family and extended family. Great to see a homegrown young man succeed and do as well as you have. Next up, we have the Catholic Charities, I believe.
We got everybody here.
Everybody here from Catholic Charities? Okay.
Dean, you want to bring Omasi up and Darcy?
Darcy?
You guys weren't shy yesterday, so come on.
All of a sudden, everybody wants to stand up.
Well, yesterday we kicked off on National Recovery Month. The Congressman Maloney, the DA, Assemblywoman Gunther, Assemblyman Skoupis, and obviously it's an entire month that we want to spread the word about recovery, not only for alcohol but for opiates. And you know, it's a major issue here in Orange County. We are one of the top places for overdoses. And just about a week and a half ago, and I wanted to bring this up yesterday, this Saturday will be 2 weeks that one of our sheriff deputies at 10 o'clock on Saturday night gave Narcan to a young man, I think he was 32 years old, in the town of Hamptonburg, and gave him a second chance at life. So you talk about guys like Victor, law enforcement today are given a godlike power. We had one in Chester that revived a guy four separate times, gave a guy four separate times at life to clean their act up again. It's a serious epidemic. Everybody here are just the top notch in Orange County. I know every one of you personally, and we need to work harder on this. We need to get more funding. We need to put the funding in the right areas, and it's a collaborative effort. And you know, we run a jail of 1,000 beds, and it's a great opportunity there to help people with addiction problems. We also do programs for youth throughout the different levels in school that we got to continue to grow and build on. And every one of the legislators at one point has participated with me in these different areas. But we need to do more. And we deal with this on a daily basis. Darcy and I, in particular, in emergency management and the crisis impact of what happens. So we need to talk about the positive things that happen with recovery as well. We talked yesterday, somebody talked about 4 years it took somebody to get whatever it takes. We're humans, we want to help people. So with that, Steve, I'll yield to you, and if you want to ask each one to say a few words real quick about it, or Dean, or...
I think the county exec pretty much covered it. We respect the job that you do, and, you know, keep doing it. And Charlie Quinn, another Montgomery guy. I always have to mention that, sorry. But,
Cornwall and Hudson now?
Yeah, he's calling it Montgomery. I give up. But thank you. Who wants to speak? Steve will do the proclamation.
I'll just say a quick word. I want to just say that this is a very exceptional county. I've worked in behavioral health for over 40 years. I've been in this county working for 42 years. And the collaboration between county government, between the Department of Social Services, Department of Mental Health, and other agencies is very unique and very exceptional. And Orange County, in that regard, is a very progressive county. And I'm just happy to be here, as I'm sure all of my peers and colleagues are.
Well, we're happy to have you as a partner. Chris or Linda, anybody else?
Just real quick.
They were also at a press conference we just had to try to deal with emergency stuff related to Zika virus. We have 7 now confirmed cases in Orange County of people that have gotten in traveling, and it's becoming a larger concern across this country. And Linda, one of our partners from Cornerstone, I'm not saying the rest, I'm sticking with Cornerstone.
It's good. It's good. So I just want to tell you that, and Darcy knows this as well, that people in recovery want to do the right thing. They want to get well. We have over 450 people who come in every day for their methadone. And those, out of the 450, we've trained 110 people. 110 people in recovery how to use Narcan. That 110 have flipped open their pack 11 times, which means they saved 11 lives of people who were like them before they were in recovery. That is a testament to how strong the partnership is between the Department of Mental Health and Social Services, our county executive, our the sheriff, to really understand that this is a chronic illness that we need to treat, and we need to treat it strongly because our children, our families, our moms, our dads, our aunts, our uncles, our grandmas and grandpas, we are one toothpick away from being addicted to an opioid. So, thank you.
Thank you very much. Does anybody else want to speak? I'll let the county executive proclamation, but I do have to say that I probably should have invited Matt Turnbull down. He is our go-to guy when it comes to recovery issues. It's near and dear to his heart, and he's our expert in the legislature. But we're fully supportive of what you do, and it's good to hear that we do such a great job, our people, our representatives, and that helps us make decisions in October and November to help you do what you do. So, County Exec.
Matt, you coming down? We're guilty doing it. You know, like yesterday when Linda spoke, and she kind of paraphrased it today, she said, you don't know of a kid when they're young that says they say they want to be a teacher, they want to be a doctor, they want to be a cop, they want to be in the military. Nobody ever says I want to be a heroin addict. And that's what this is all about. So, Matt, you want to say a few words?
Yeah, thank you, the debate continues with my wife whether I'm a recovered person or a recovering person. 35 years. It's the one time I'll clap for myself. But I'm sure Steve wasn't citing a statistic we're proud of when he said, you know, Orange County has a high number of people suffering from this disease. But what I would just like to say is to remind everybody that people who come in looking for help really struggle with the concept that they suffer from a disease. Because to them, they look at it and they wonder why they're not like everybody else, you know, why they can't just stop, you know. So if we could just remember that one thing when we deal with people that suffer from addictions, you know, they're powerless over those addictions and they need our help. It's good to know that there's a lot of help here in Orange County, and I'm confident that we're gonna do a good job. Thank you.
Do you want to, Matt? You have to stay up here. Should we just? You're a boss. You did this yesterday. Kristen.
And our final resolution, County Executive, you want to stay with us? I'll invite Legislator Phil Cantorino down. I guess we have a resolution for the Papagni boys. I assume you two are the Papagni boys. If you want to come up with your parents, I'll let Phil give a little synopsis of the great work you've done, and I'll say a couple words afterwards.
That's great. This is a great story with a great ending. Drove down the street a number of times, and on the corner of Minnison Trail and Phillipsburg Road, there is this lemonade stand with two young entrepreneurs holding signs. They have this big lemonade stand and lines of cars on both roads, both sides of the roads. And I'm like, I'm on the Economic Development Committee. I better find out what's going on. So I did. I got out and I said, okay, tell me what's going on. And they said, you know, they explained their business model. And first off, it was a great product, good service at a reasonable price. I'm like, okay, that works for me. So, but really, the story goes on. I said, so why are you raising all of these funds? And they were out there every day, 7 days a week, morning, night, all day, sun, rain. And they said, well, we're raising money, so when we go to Disney World, we have some unrestricted funds, which means they didn't have to ask anybody, we're just gonna buy it. So I can't imagine how much they made. Well, these are businessmen with a heart. Because somewhere along the line near the end, they found out that there was a toy drive, and there were children at Mount Sinai Hospital that were sick and had toys. Choked up. And these boys donated a part of their proceeds to that charity. So I am so proud of them. Thank you. Just read the certificate award, and it's a Distinguished Service Award in the County of Orange, presented to Marco and Anthony Papagni for your lemonade stand, funding efforts, and outstanding community service gifts, first day of September of 2016. So congratulations.
Okay, first, I'd like to... Yes, Victor, you can leave if you want. It gets a little boring after this, probably. But thanks for coming again. Congratulations to up the great work, all you guys. Remembering our good friend, former county legislator, former commissioner of jurors, Dennis Simmons, I will recognize Tom Pagino, legislator Pagino.
Thank you, Chairman. As many of you know, we lost a good friend recently in former county legislator Dennis Simmons. I know so many of you here have reached out to me personally and have expressed your feelings about his passing. I just wanted to let some of you know who may not have known just a little bit about who Dennis meant, who he was, and what he meant to me. I met Dennis Simmons when I was about 13, 14 years old. I was a young football player in Port Jervis, and he was one of our football coaches. And I told his wife Carla and his brother Dave, Dave was one of the other football coaches, I told them recently, I said, you know, when I first met Dennis, he was a cross between God and an insane drill instructor. And he was every bit of a coach that you always wanted to have as a coach. He was very stern, he was very direct. Sometimes he was mean, and especially being 13, 14 years old, you know, I was a bit scared of him. But I know one thing, he always got 100% out of all of us young players. And he taught us more about life than he did about football. And there were two things that he taught me when I was 13, 14 years old that I still hold on to today. And that is, he always taught us to stand up for what we believe in and to give 100% maximum effort. And as he matured in his life, and he obviously was in the city council of the city of Port Jervis and then came here to the county, I know, and I'm sure so many of you can all relate to the fact that he definitely was a man of principle, and he was a man that definitely stood up. And I was very fortunate last year when he took the position of the Commissioner of Jurors to follow in his footsteps and to assume his seat right here. And he came into my little shop about a year ago when this was all coming together, and he kind of gave me a little bit of his old coaching. And and to the day he passed, I always called him coach, and I still will. So I'm sorry to hear that he passed, and I appreciate the time, Chad.
Thank you. Anyone else want to say a few words about Dennis? Jeff?
I didn't call Dennis coach. I didn't have quite the intimate relationship you did, but I did call him friend, and I really admired his independence. He had guts. He could take unpopular positions, and he was friendly about it, at least to me. We were kind of unlikely friends in a lot of ways. We were quite different with different outlooks on things, but I always enjoyed his friendship. We would comment about that, how unlikely it was for us to share this relationship. And then one other thing that we shared in common was a respect for Israel, which I don't know if anybody else talked to him about that, but I did. And he was a strong friend of the state of Israel too, and a great American patriot.
Thank you, Jeff. Matt?
I ran into Dennis a couple of times. We were kind of sharing some of the same medical problems, I guess, and we run into each other in the waiting room. And the way out, my wife asked me who he was. So that's a guy who is a two-fisted, direct guy that you really respect. I remember thinking to myself that, I didn't know why they put the word honorable in front of our names. You know, it's kind of a joke in my house. I was trying to get my wife to call me honorable. But, then I met Dennis, and I kind of understood what that word meant. I had respect for the guy. That's all I could say. We often differed on issues, but he would come up and talk to you afterwards, and I really respect that. I think we need more of that. Certainly what we see going on in the country, guys like Dennis are, they're not a dime a dozen, but they're certainly power examples.
Anyone else? Oh, Michael Amel, I'm sorry.
Thank you. Okay, thank you. Thank you, Chairman. I've known Dennis for a real long time, but I didn't really know that I knew him. And I'll tell you what I mean by that. In 1978, I took a job at the Mid-Hudson Forensic Psychiatric Hospital as a director of training, education and training for the hospital, and then subsequently moved up. And one of the days on my rounds throughout the ward, I met this guy named Dennis Simmons, who was a security hospital treatment assistant. I think the women's ward. And it's just something about the way he talked to me and the way he talked about things set him apart so much from the other 250 people that worked there. I was just so impressed. So I kept talking to him more and learned more about his background and how he left West Point and what he'd been doing. And realized that he had not finished his degree. And so I put it as my job to get him hooked up with Empire State College and try to work it out so he'd get his degree and get on to do the things that he really deserved to do. And that's it. He did it. He went off and did what he did. And I never remembered him again. He was just an employee. So I'm in the legislature. One day I'm at an event, and he walks up to me and says, "You don't remember me." Dennis Simmons, And I have the same feeling everybody else has for him. What a respectable guy. He just stood out. So he still stands out in my mind, and I'm sorry I was away last week and unable to be part of the process, but he does.
Anybody else? I will recognize Melissa last. Myrna?
I sat right next to Dennis on the stage. I had a perspective of him that I have not yet heard anybody else mention. The fact that he had a wonderful sense of humor. Sometimes we put our head together because you had two different people in size and in political bent. But he had a wonderful sense of humor.
Absolutely. I concur with that. I was the brunt of that sense of humor many a day. But if anybody else is going to say anything, I'm going to recognize you after. I'll say, I know you want to finish up. I don't know what to say about Dennis. I mean, I had a lot of good times with him. Utmost respect. I mean, he excelled at almost anything that he did, whether it was sports or academics or legislature or what you name it. I mean, even when he interviewed for the commissioner of jurors, the two judges were very impressed with the interview, as was I. And his resume speaks for itself. And it's a shame that the Times Herald Record couldn't have done a nice story about Dennis, because not many people accomplish as much as in a lifetime as he did in so many different realms. He was an exceptional individual. I mean, I used to sit where John Bureau sits, and he and Roxanne used to sit right next to each other. It was fun to see them debate because they both speak loud enough as if they were talking to somebody across the room, sitting right next to each other, looking ahead, and both passionate individuals and great debates and respectful of each other afterwards. You know, it made the legislature worthwhile. We got things done. Dennis, if you don't know, I'm sure he wrote that obituary because he didn't leave anything out. Melissa and Tom Fagione and I went to the funeral at the church last Friday, and the priest said that Dennis was a detail person, and he certainly was. I mean, he didn't miss any details, but I'm glad he wrote that obituary because everything was in there, and he just gave this community so much. I mean, he was like our John Wayne of the legislature. He was a tough individual, passionate, and he did his homework, too. I mean, he knew what he was saying. He ran a great rules meeting, ran great other meetings as well. Council was invaluable, organized. You just name it. I mean, the man was what you really, a gentleman that you look up to. And he was my right-hand man in the legislature. There's no doubt about it, even before I was chair. And I'm going to miss him immensely. It's still hasn't hit home yet with me. But I just... I'm going to miss him, that's all I have to say. Melissa?
Thank you. There are a lot of things I can say about Dennis, because I've known Dennis for many years, but I apologize because I wrote down some thoughts, because for me it's emotional, I apologize. Dennis was my friend. He was my colleague, but he was my friend first. And I admired so many things about him. His honesty, as Matt alluded to before, his ability to agree, disagree, and then move on. Shake your hand and move on to the next issue. Personally, I'm going to miss his advice when I needed it. I reached out to him quite often, whether just picked up the phone or we talked in person. I'm even going to miss his sarcasm and wit and his sense of humor, as you said, because he was full of his jokes and comments and always made you laugh. So I'm glad that you touched on that as well. But the last thing that I wanted to share was I always admired his strength as an individual, no matter what the issue was. But I truly admired it. I had the opportunity, I guess the privilege, to see Dennis 3 days before he passed in his home. And his strength really became apparent to me then, because he was consoling me. And he was telling me that it's okay, and I'm the one breaking down. He was very strong, and I'm going to miss his friendship as well, as a lot of you are, and I'm going to miss him. Thank you.
That was okay until you spoke, Melissa. He's down. He's up there looking down, smiling. Yep. Public participation. We have, I guess,
First up is Mary Ann McDonough, Mount Hope, regarding the John McCary appointment.
I'm a little confused. The Times Herald Record newspaper article, which I have with me, says county department had to return, and that article was dated 8/21, and informed me that this full legislature today is voting on whether to allow John McCary to retire from his post and return 2 weeks later. Yet when I read the agenda item, which I also have with me, this legislative body relative to Mr. McCary, item number 27, all it states is reappointment of John McCary, Director of Real Property, 10/12/16 to 9/30/19, by Orange County Executive. I'm particularly troubled by the verbiage in the Times Herald Record article that appears to be conspicuously absent from the county agenda and the full ramifications of what you are voting on today. Your resolution makes it appear that John McCary is just being reappointed for 3 years. It says nothing about collecting a full salary and a full pension. Let me speak to the justification the county executive Newhouse has quoted in the Times Herald Record as to why taxpayers should be funding a full salary and a full pension for the same job. I think the term is known as double dipping. County Executive Steve Newhouse told the Personnel and Compensation Committee on Monday, if God forbid John passed away today, his wife would not be protected with a good retirement. I believe this statement is disingenuous. What they have neglected to tell you is that should God forbid Mr. McCary pass away as a county employee without being retired, his wife or whoever he designated as a beneficiary would receive a death benefit. In my day, usually that death benefit was 3 times the employee's salary. While I have done some rudimentary research on death benefit payments for those eligible for retirement and still employed, I don't have the particulars of Mr. McCary's, how long he's been in office, his tier, et cetera, so I can't comment on what he would be getting. And also, if I am missing something, if there's something that Mr. McCary's position does not allow him to get a death benefit while in office, I would appreciate being edified about that. Many of the regular folks I talked to upon seeing this newspaper article stated that they too would love to collect a full salary and a full pension. Unfortunately, it appears that only some are able to do this. Others, much lower on the pay scale, not 92,780 as reported by the record, must struggle to continue working despite their retirement age eligibility and because they cannot afford to retire. I guess this is one more glaring example that Bernie spoke of when he said there's economic inequality in America. There was an article I pulled up by the Fiscal Times dated 8/17/11 by an author named Andrew Yarrow, and it says the taxpayer shouldn't be responsible for providing individuals with 2 streams of income. Stephen Malanga, a senior fellow at the Manhattan Institute, written extensively on double dipping by retired workers. He said it isn't fraud, but it's costly loopholes. And it illustrates how poorly we've designed some of our government retirement work programs. Ultimately, the arguments are not about legality or fraud or even government oversight. It comes to philosophical questions about the safety net, America, and how to balance social need with fiscal responsibility. I request all 21 legislatures delay this vote until you thoroughly research the financial and philosophical implications of your vote today to say exactly what you're voting on. Are you voting for a simple 3-year extension of an appointment, or are you in fact voting to authorize another double dipper for Orange County? Please do not be fooled by the alleged that is providing. One more sentence. We as taxpayers fund the salaries of our government employees, and we also fund their retirement benefits. So this is no savings for Orange County. This approval of Resolution 27, as I understand it, not as it's written down right now, will have us taxpayers
paying
twice.
That's more than one more sentence.
That's it.
Okay, thank you. Sherry Kleiner, Alderman, City of Middletown, regarding Indigo, item number one.
Good afternoon. I apologize, I'm going to have to leave immediately after this. I just meeting about now. Also apologize, I'm not going to talk about Montgomery. I'm going to talk about
that's okay.
Some of the issues I heard raised in the two committees, I just wanted to speak briefly. The original memorandum of understanding between the mayor and the county executive gave us a deadline of July 15th. We had to have a special meeting. would be null and void. It turned out that the county executive was able to extend the legislature's deadline for 2 months, so that's why it's September 15th. This is not a sudden deal like a special meeting would indicate. This negotiation and going on for a long time. Middletown had permission to build a reservoir there in the 1960s. Those days are long gone. In the drought of the 80s, we had an agreement with the county to, on a temporary and emergency basis, take water from the Indigo, which we have done. That agreement was, I believe it had expired, but it was renewed in 2013. County Executive Diana. So we have pipes there. We've been taking water there for some time. We know it's there. The Mid-County Study Group, I believe it was 2008 or 2009, and a lot of those meetings that we, Middletown at that time applied for and received from the state a grant to do those exploratory wells. So Middletown's initiative and agreement with the county to see what water resources were truly there. I think they've only done 7 wells. I know it was a very wet period and they weren't able to do as much exploration as they wanted to. This agreement is non-exclusive. Other people can also, providers could also take water from there. Does reserve the county's right to subdivide for future residential development on the land. That specifically guarantees riparian rights will be preserved for the entire area. Our environmental review was a type 1. Some people just wanted to do a type 2 because it was simply a leasing agreement. But I'm sure that the agreement specifies that all applicable laws will be followed. There is much left to be determined environmentally because we don't know what's involved. The agreement does say that every effort will be made after the engineering reviews to absolutely minimize the footprint and physical size and area of any construction necessary. Middletown does already have the infrastructure there, and Middletown would be assuming all the expenses and all the risks of any development there and of any infrastructure. Everything needed to provide water, the county will simply benefit from any sale of water by the city. And as you all know, of course, the Ames deal, their rate is dependent on this agreement. I think it's a win for both sides. Hopefully it'll provide water to the businesses on the 17M corridor. It does allow Middletown to join the county in applying for tax reductions, if that's what you would like to do. County determines they want to do that, but at this point, any talk about Middletown actually paying all the taxes on that, understanding would be a deal. Or it is just the leasing agreement. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, Majority Leader Bonsack.
Thank you. I move to approve the minutes of July 7, 2016.
Second.
If there are no objections, these items will be voted on collectively. Majority Leader Bonsack again.
I move to vote collectively on agenda items numbers 11 through 13 and 15 through 23.
Second. Okay, no objections. We'll be done. Okay, are there any referrals, withdrawals, or consents? Majority Leader Bonsack.
Okay, Mr. Chairman.
Yes.
I just want to make sure that I had a prepared consent, which was a companion resolution to number one, but it's my understanding that number one will not be voted on today. So then I don't need a consent.
Your consent will go back with that to committee, I believe, for 1 month. That's what you're going to say, right? Took the words out of your mouth?
I'll read that one first. I actually
need
to.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay, so I request that item number one on the agenda, resolution of the Orange County Legislature approving an easement agreement by and between the County of Orange and the City of Middletown, permitting access on and to a portion of county property known as the Indigo Reservoir Site, and authorizing the county executive to execute documents in relation thereto, be withdrawn and referred back to committees for 1 month.
Second.
Okay, if there are no objections, that'll be done. Okay. Can we get a second? Oh, you have a second one. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Thank you. I request consent to replace resolution, agenda item number 9, resolution authorizing the private sale and conveyance of certain county-owned lands acquired by reason of failure to redeem said lands from a tax sale to Orange County pursuant to section 1136 of the real property tax law and section 5, paragraph A1 of the Orange County amended local law number 2 of 2010. Replacing it with a resolution that removes the town of Deer Park parcel 1-1-31, since the property owner paid their taxes, and it adds the town of Mount Hope parcel 19-1-29, because the town of Mount Hope is considering partnering with the state DEC in preserving the lands for open space.
Second. Okay, if there are no objections, that revision will be made with the new number 9. All right, on to number 1, or A is receiving file, 1A is receiving file, okay, now number 1. Number 2, I'm sorry. Number
2. Legislators Kemmons and DeSalvo, resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Department of Planning to accept and appropriate supplemental funds as a subcontractor to the Orange County Department of Health pursuant to section 99-H of the General Municipal Law and section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Onasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Nagnostakis? Berkman? Pantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ekis? Fagione? Hines? Kemenitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Bureau? Brescia? 18 ayes.
Okay, number 3.
Legislators Ruskevich and Turnbull. Resolution of the Orange County Legislature giving notice of intent to assume lead agency status under State Environmental Quality Review Act (SEQRA) with respect to the replacement of Denton Bridge in the town of Minising, making a preliminary determination that this project be classified as an unlisted action.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Onasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Berkman? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ekis, Fagione, Hines, Kemenitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Bureau, Brescia, 18 ayes.
Number 4.
Legislators Benelli and Benton, resolution of the Orange County Legislature giving notice of intent to assume lead agency status under State Environmental Quality Review Act (SEQRA) with respect to the replacement of the Otisville Viaduct in the village of Otisville, making a preliminary determination that this project be listed as an unlisted action.
Second.
Question? Yes. You want to be a sponsor, Melissa? Okay, Tom? And everybody got the picture of the viaduct too, right? Okay. All right, roll call.
Onasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Nagnostakis? Berkman? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ekis? Fagione? Hines, Kemenitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Bureau, Brescia, 18 ayes.
Number 5. Two-thirds vote, sorry.
Legislators Ruskevich, Benelli, and Kulisek. Bond resolution dated September 1st, 2016. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing financing for planning the replacement of Otisville Viaduct in the village of Otisville, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $100,000, appropriating said amount therefore and authorizing the issuance of 100,000 bonds of the county to finance said appropriation.
Second.
Question? Yes, Jeff. Yes, you can. Sponsor Melissa. Tom.
Onasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Nagnostakis? Berkman? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ekis? Fagione? Hines? Kemenitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Bureau, Brescia, 18 ayes.
And number 6.
Legislators Bureau, Kulisek, Benelli, Hines. Resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Department of Public Works Airport to accept and appropriate funds from the Federal Aviation Administration pursuant to Section 99-H of the General Municipal Law and Section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Coniston?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagostakis? Berkman? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Bureau? Gresham? 18 ayes.
Okay, number seven.
Legislators Anagostakis, Kulisek. Resolution authorizing the county executive to accept a gift of approximately 12 acres of vacant land in the town of Newburgh pursuant to Section 215 of the county law.
Second.
Discussion?
Yes.
Yes. Legislator Ickes.
Thank you, Chairman. In accepting a gift, as we're doing here, it doesn't come with any types of restrictions or anything else or requirements. When we accept a gift like this, that's all it is, right? It's a clean acceptance.
Well, sometimes there are conditions then. Also, when you accept property, you take it subject to items that come out in the title report. So, for instance, there may be easements on the property and such. That we don't have that information here before us. It's to accept the property as is, 12 acres of vacant land. So any restrictions would be contained within the current deed. So we would be taking it subject to that.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, roll call.
Coniston?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagostakis? Berkman? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Bureau? Gresham? 18 ayes.
Number eight.
Legislators Hines and Berkman, resolution authorizing the private sale and conveyance of certain county-owned lands acquired by reason of a failure to redeem said lands from a tax sale to Orange County pursuant to Section 10184 of the Real Property Tax Law and Orange County Amended Local Law Number 2 of 2010.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Coniston?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagostakis? Berkman? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagion? Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Bureau, Gresham, 18 ayes.
Number nine.
Legislators Hines and Berkman, resolution authorizing the private sale and conveyance of certain county-owned lands acquired by reason of a failure to redeem said lands from a tax sale to Orange County pursuant to Section 1136 of the Real Property Tax Law and Section 5, Paragraph A1 of Orange County Amended Local Law Number 2 of 2010.
Second.
Question.
Yes.
Please remove my name as the sponsor.
Right.
I apologize for having missed my meetings this last month. Otherwise, I would have been up on this. I don't understand. I want to start by saying thank you, Melissa, for what you did in attaching that property and so on like that. I think that's a very worthy cause, and I'm all for that. What I don't understand about this is these are all sales to municipalities, and they are all at more than the taxes owed on them. So in other words, we're taking advantage of a situation where we're taking monies from local municipalities, and I believe it's in the tune of $16,000, almost $16,000. And I don't think that that's our intent, or should be our intent. I, and it was confirmed by our attorney, I realize that there might have been some costs in going through the foreclosure process and maybe advertising it and all, but I think in the tune of $16,000 is way too much. And I think this would be an opportunity for us to perhaps, offer these lands. I want to get our money back. I want our back taxes paid. That's money that is due and owing us, there's no question. But I don't think that we need to make that much money on the backs of our municipalities. So I'd like to ask if we can't table this for 1 month and see if we can't perhaps go back and take a look at it and be a little kinder to all of our municipalities.
Brian, you want to speak to that? Come on up and Kelly will give you a speech. Shed light before we go for a table.
Thank you. All those properties, we made all those municipal whole on those taxes over the years. We use the September numbers for the number back tax numbers. Many times those properties take an extra month or two to close. So we did increase slightly. If something was $798, we may have made $1,000. It's not like we made a lot of money onto it, because we need to make sure we can cover the taxes if there's an extra month or two go by. And we made all the communities whole, okay? The reason you cannot table it is our public auction is going to be September 29th and September 30th. And in order to remove them from the auction, it must be approved this meeting. Otherwise, they will be going to a public auction.
Hey, Kevin, did you want to speak to this too?
Yeah, I did. I agree with Mr. Berkman. I did not sponsor this in committee. Please remove my name. I don't know if it was a typo, but it came over from number 8 or what. But my notes reflect I did not, so maybe we could go back to the original minutes of the meeting and add those sponsors, but please remove mine.
Okay, do we need sponsors right now, or can we should have sponsors before we vote on it yet. Does anybody want to step up to the plate and be a sponsor? Alyssa? Okay. And Matt? Okay. Any more discussion on the part?
Point of order in yes. regards to sponsors. I was under the impression, and this is why I have a concern, because there are a couple of resolutions here that I purposely made the motion for in committee, hoping that my name would be put on as a sponsor, and it wasn't. So this is a perfect example of what's going on here now. How do we determine who the sponsors are if you're not actually taking notes and putting down whoever's making the motion as the sponsor?
Normally the statutory chairs do that, and they normally give the sponsors at the end of their statutory meeting.
So whether or not you're making a motion for it, you can still be put down as a sponsor by the committee chair?
Quite possibly, yes.
Is that what you're saying?
Or you can object to it when it comes to the floor, and your name could be taken off just like it was just
totally
done.
Totally up to the committee chair, and that's it, right?
To put the sponsors on, correct. It's been that way. It's going to continue to be that way. Okay.
Yeah. Michael wants to be a sponsor, too.
I just wanted to address your what you said before, that you had sponsored in committee but didn't end up on here. And I just have to tell you, before I was majority leader serving as chair of committees, a lot of times when people would go to make a motion in a second, several people were saying it at once, so you just pick two and put it down on the list for the ladies, for the resolution. So I don't think that it's ever anything malicious. I think it's just what we hear. And we write down the first two names that we hear. So I just wanted to mention that as a past chair.
Legislator, were you done, Roseanne? I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Okay. Legislator Anagnostakis.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Chairman. And for Ms. Sullivan, to make it even more clear, I'm a current chairman of the committee. And when people make a motion in a second, that's to get the item onto the agenda to talk about it during the committee. The chairman is 100% correct. The chairman of the committee has the ability to decide who are the sponsors of that particular resolution. And I always take it, and you've had personal experience with me, I take it upon myself to talk to people if it impacts their area, specifically in the county, and say, would you like to be a sponsor of this? I think this will do you good to be a sponsor. And if the person would like to, I put them on as a sponsor when it doesn't good in their particular area. So it is the chairman of the committee that has the ultimate decision as to who sponsors are.
Yes, Legislator.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I just would like to say I agree with Chris. Many times when these tax parcels come before some physical services or ways and means, wherever they come, there's been at least, 33-50% of the time, we sell the property for less than the back taxes. So I would agree with Chris as why we would maybe look at overcharging a municipality for a parcel, when in fact we've let hundreds of parcels go for less than the taxes. So I'm a little sketchy on this one myself.
You have other discussion? Roll call.
Onasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Berkman? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ickes?
No.
Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk?
No.
Ruskevich? Sullivan?
No.
Bureau? Gresham? 15 ayes, 3 noes.
Number 10.
Legislators DeSalvo and Turnbull. Resolution approving the release of the county's interest in and to a certain detail parcel to previous owner of record pursuant to Section 5, Paragraph B1 of Local Law Number 2 of 2010.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Berkman? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo?
Yes.
Ickes? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Ruskevich, Sullivan, Bureau, Gresham, 18 ayes.
Okay, resolutions 11 through 13.
Second.
Discussion. Class. You want to be added? Yes, Jim. Okay, Tom, did you have your hand up, Tom?
Yeah.
Okay, yes, Tom. All Dems, okay. All Republicans? And Michael? Okay, you got it. Discussion. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo? Anagnostakis? Berkman? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Bureau? Gresham? 18 ayes.
Yeah, number 14.
Legislators Cantorino and Chemnitz. Resolution authorizing the county executive to accept a certain gift on behalf of the Department of Residential Health Care Services pursuant to Section 215 of the county law.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Berkman? Cantorino? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Bureau? Gresham? 18 ayes.
Okay, resolutions 15 through 23.
Second.
Discussion. All Dems?
I'd like to be added.
Not a problem. Add all Republicans. Michael. Okay, everybody. Okay, roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Berkman? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Bureau? Gresham? 18 ayes.
Okay, number 24.
Legislators Anagnostakis, Cantorino, Turnbull. Resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Office for the Aging to accept and appropriate grant funds from the New York State Office for the Aging pursuant to Section 99-H of the General Municipal Law and Section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call. Oh, yes, Roseanne's added. Jim DeSalvo name added. Okay. All right, roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Berkman? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Bureau? Gresham? 18 ayes.
Okay, number 25.
Legislators Bonasek, Anagnostakis, Amo. Resolution confirming the appointments by the County Executive to the Orange County Veterans Advisory Board Committee.
Second.
Discussion. All Republicans? All Democrats? You got it, Jim.
Okay.
And Michael, right? Already on there? Okay. I should look. All right. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Berkman? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Bureau? Brescia? 18 ayes.
Okay. Number 26.
Legislators Fagion, Cantorino, Bonasek, Anagnostakis, Amo. An act amending the appropriate Orange County employment schedules to abolish social welfare examiner and create support investigator at the Orange County Department of Social Services pursuant to Section 2.02I of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion?
Can I have my name, please?
Yes. Hey, roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Berkman? Cantorino, Cheney, DeSalvo, Ickes, Fagion, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Bureau, Brescia. 18 ayes.
Mike, did you want your name? You give me a look.
No, no, I would just, is there more than one social examiner? Singular. All of them are going to be switched to this title now?
Just,
they staying at the same grade.
No, I'm sorry, there's, it, 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 so
sorry, if you look to the right, they're deleting one social welfare examiner, grade 9, and it has a number there, 30973. So that position will be deleted, and they're adding one support investigator.
Okay, we're switching.
Okay, number 27.
Legislators Dillard, Fagion, Benelli, and Hines. Resolution confirming the reappointment of John I. McCary as Director of Real Property Tax Service for Orange County by the County Executive pursuant to Section 5.05 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Let there be more conversation. I've known John McCary for quite some time, and I know the Office of Real Property before he was there, and I know the professionalism that he's added to that agency of county government, and I think he's been a valuable person in negotiating various county contracts and just moving forward as a county. He's been quite helpful. He's got a lot of experience. That being said, I would have preferred, like I said in committee, that they would have redefined his reappointed position as an acting director, because going right back to the same title makes me pause. And also, I preferred having a reappointment for 1 year rather than the duration of the term. Some people thought that couldn't be done. I don't know why. I think it probably can, but it didn't get much support in committee anyway, but that's what I still prefer. If this resolution came before us and it was dealing with elected officials, I think I'd be pretty clear that I would oppose it. And I think that that's kind of the Albany behavior that that I don't want us to adopt. And I think that, this comes close, but it the director of real property is not an elected position, so it's distinguishable from the county, from the state example. So I had to balance the various interests, and I was told in committee, I think it was $15,000 is actually saved by the county if we go forward. 31. Should pay closer attention to Mr. Cantorino and who told me that in the parking lot. but it is a modest step forward that way, and we're in the middle of some important large projects that Mr. McCary is intimately involved with. So although this didn't come down the way I wanted it to, I think I have to prove it on balance of the totality of factors.
Okay. Roll call.
Monison?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis?
No.
Berkman? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ekus? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Bureau? Gresham? 17 ayes, 1 no.
Congratulations, Mr. McCary. You're with us another 3 years, I think. Then you're going to retire, you think? That's what you said anyway. We'll see. Okay. Congratulations. Okay, number 28. He is retired. Not yet. Not until the 29th of September. Smart aleck. Okay, 28.
Legislators Benton, Cantorino, DeSalvo, and Berkman. An act amending the appropriate Orange County employment schedules to create two assessors, clerks, part-time positions at the Orange County Department of Finance, Division of Real Property Tax Service Agency, pursuant to Section 2.02I of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Onison?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Berkman? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ekus? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Bureau, Gresham, 18 ayes.
And number 29.
Legislators Benton, Cantorino, and Anagnostakis, and Turnbull. an act amending the appropriate Orange County employment schedules to reallocate real property tax assistant at the Orange County Department of Finance, Division of Real Property Tax Service Agency, pursuant to Section 2.02I of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Onaset?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Berkman? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Gresham? 18 ayes.
Okay, number 30.
Legislators Benton, Cantorino, Benelli, Kulisek. An act amending the appropriate Orange County employment schedules to reclassify senior account clerk to principal account clerk at the Orange County Department of Finance, Division of Real Property Tax Service Agency, pursuant to Section 2.02I of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Onaset?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Berkman? Cantorino? Cheney? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Gresham? 18 ayes, Mr. Chairman, and the desk is clear.
Thank you. Yes, Legislator Hines.
Yeah, if you would, I'd like to add a little something. I have something hot off the press here, which is near and dear to my heart, and everybody here supported a resolution with respect to the Cornwall Hospital. So the Cornwall Hospital made an announcement today, which just came out public. I got wind of it this morning, but now that it's public, I'd like to read it real quick. It says, for public, immediate public release, September 1st, 2016, St. Luke's Cornwall Hospital has always taken the voices of our local leadership and community seriously, and in particular, Senator Larkin, whose leadership we have relied upon for many years. We will be taking a pause in our application for closure, and will continue to operate the emergency department and associated services until questions about the Cornwall campus emergency department transition and access to care are addressed with our local leaders and elected officials, including Congressman Maloney, Senator Larkin, and Assemblyman Skoufis. The St. Luke's Cornwall Hospital remains dedicated to maintaining our community access to the highest quality health care in the most appropriate patient setting. Good communication is an important part of that process. We thank our community for their input and are confident that together we will move forward successfully. So this is a temporary pause while they work with us. It's very important to us. I did talk to Brendan Casey this morning about it because I got wind of it. We're not done with respect to our Indian Point plans yet, so they were scrambling with FEMA to do that. So this is going to also buy us time to get those plans in order. They're not saying that the emergency room is going to stay open forever, but the October 1st date is now gone and they're going to address it. So I thank everybody here who helped with that resolution, and I don't know if it helped, but we all did our part. Thank you.
Thank you, Kevin, for you spearheading that effort on behalf of the legislature. Before we adjourn, I just would remind everyone that the air show is this Saturday and Sunday. Try to attend if you can. September 10th is General Montgomery Day. Many of you are coming in the parade. That same day, I think Middletown has their parade and Honor Flight and Way Way Yonder Day and a few other things. So it's a busy day. So I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
Second.